The mystery behind the discovery of the cremated remains of 56 people continues to grow even deeper tonight. Good evening, I'm Mark Allen.
And I'm Pam Elliott. The remains were found at a home owned by a former funeral director who had her license revoked and her business shut down late last year. Jordan Burgess is live. The discovery that officials say really makes this case even more difficult.
Well, this case seems to grow stranger by the hour. Now, right now, officials here at the Montgomery County Coroner's Office are trying to contact the family members of those whose remains were found. But that could prove to be difficult because we've discovered that some of those remains date back as far as 20 years ago, which raises even more questions about why they weren't properly buried in the first place. A case as baffling as it is bizarre.
This office has never experienced a situation like we have here.
The Montgomery County Coroner's Office is now the current resting place of the cremains of 56 people. But finding them final resting places won't be easy. Some of the remains date back as far as 1992. The last ones, 2009.
There's a lifetime of collection here, and that's going to make things probably maybe a little more difficult.
Two News was there yesterday as the remains were discovered in the closet of a foreclosed Philadelphia Drive home owned by the former director of the McLinn Funeral Home, Sherry McLinn, and her sister, Tanya Anderson. We've since learned the remains are the same ones spotted earlier this year in the funeral home during an investigation by the Ohio Board of Embalmers and Funeral Directors, but the board didn't have the authority to take them at the time. Now, investigators are looking for clues about why the cremains were kept for so long.
This is a deliberate retention of someone's remains, and I think that's a question that needs to be answered for the community.
We're told all the cremains were in boxes, complete with names and the date of death. That's what the coroner's office has to go on to track down family members. No matter what, officials vow to bring peace to those whose remains have been in limbo for so long.
If families do not claim, this office will take the responsibility to ensure that closure on these cases and these individuals is made.
Now, we've talked with Montgomery County prosecutors. They tell us they're not sure about charges in this case, but they are still investigating some unaccounted for pre-burial funds with the McLinn Funeral Home, and charges could end up stemming from that investigation. And you can bet we'll continue to follow this situation. But for now, reporting live, Jordan Burgess, 2 News.
Now, we checked this out further because we, like you, had questions about Ohio law regarding this. State officials tell us whoever cremates a body is ultimately responsible for disposing of those remains. If someone is designated the recipient of cremated remains but does not pick them up within 30 days, the company may deliver them to that person. However, if next of kin is not listed on the cremation order form and someone does not claim the remains within 60 days, the company may place them in a grave, crypt, or niche.